హాయ్, వెల్కమ్ టు మై ఛానల్. నా ఛానల్కి మీ అందరికీ స్వాగతం. లైక్ అండ్ షేర్ ది వీడియో, సబ్స్క్రైబ్ మై ఛానల్. ఫర్ నోటిఫికేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ న్యూ వీడియోస్ ప్లీజ్ క్లిక్ ది బెల్ ఐకాన్. ఈ వీడియోని లైక్ అండ్ షేర్ చేయండి, నా ఛానల్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి. కొత్త వీడియోల నోటిఫికేషన్స్ కోసం పక్కనే ఉన్న బెల్ ఐకాన్ని క్లిక్ చేయండి. Four horse scene. What is the four horse scene? It is an end times scene, that is an apocalyptic scene where four forces of destruction show up on horses. So what is this showing up on horses? Showing up on horses means they are also nothing but four forms of the second coming of Jesus, that is Lord Kalki. So these are not something totally different from second coming of Jesus, because Jesus is also depicted to be coming on horse wielding a sword, same as Kalki. So we will look into how these four horses are one person and how they are nothing but Lord Kuja, which I explained in previous videos, how they'll start as Lord Kuja. We will see into this. As I have said previously, the end times are represented by only one person, that is Lord Parabrahma, who comes as Kalki and who is nothing but even the second coming of Jesus. Jesus is Esu Narayana, so he is Lord Vishnu, and Vishnu is a part of Parabrahma, the main part, the soul of Parabrahma, so he will be residing in Parabrahma, that is Kalki. And then I told that the unholy trinity consisting of Satan, the Antichrist or beast, and the false prophet are nothing but one person, that is Kalki, Jesus, and he is seen as unholy because, as I told in the Islamic apocalypse, they have said it that it's a psychological warfare, because all religions should turn back to Hinduism and the worship of many gods, that is Indra, etc., Dikpalaka, Zeus. Indra is Zeus. The worship of many gods should restart, because either the protective layer of many gods or many religions should be there to allow people to worship Parabrahma in a safe way. The one true God, Parabrahma, is the ultimate one true God. To worship him, we should be facilitated either by many gods layer, protective layer, or many religions protective layer, in which many religions protective layer is just a temporary protective layer, and in that also the various forms of Parabrahma, that is the current Hindu pantheon of gods, they are all not different gods, they are not many gods, they are just false gods, that is pseudo false gods. So they act as a pseudo protective layer for the time being, where world is following many religions. So they are just many forms of the same one true God, like you have many names for the same one true God in each religion. We have different forms, and it acts as a pseudo protective layer for the time being. So this second coming or the final stage of where Lord Parabrahma comes as Kalki, or second coming of Jesus, he first shows up in this form of Kuja, that is the son of Vishnu. Kuja is equivalent to Aries in the Western pantheon, but Aries is son of Zeus, but Kuja is not son of Indra, he is son of Indra's brother Vishnu, so he is nephew of Indra, So here Ares is nephew of Zeus, not son. It's a little bit complicated. Please check into this matter personally for further details. But here it's a bit difficult. Anyhow, it's the warlord. In the form of warlord, he shows up. So the first of the four horses is war. War is nothing but warlord Ares, that is Kuja, Mars. So Kuja means war, blood, red, and earth, and he is born from earth. You know, earth is red in color. So, and earth is the final source for electricity. We say grounding wire, earth wire. So from on lightning, that is the weapon of Indra or Zeus, Kuja rides it, Ares rides it, because lightning is nothing but electricity mainly. And then it reaches earth, that is people also. It will attack people. And apart from that, we know that there is a magnetic field in earth which will produce electric, which is produced by the ionization of molten lava magma inside. So the current is there, power, electricity is there inside the earth, and that gives the magnetic field also. So as we know, this is all related to earth. And Bhaumya, Kuja is known as Bhaumya, that is born of Bhumi, a matronymic name. It is Bhaumya. So Kuja means warlord in Vaishnavism sect of Hinduism, and the counterpart in Shaivism sect is Kumara Swami Kartikeya. It's a bit complicated, please refer into it later. So I said the first plague would be electricity plague. That is what? So war, and war is also a kind of plague. So the second horseman plague, he is also nothing but, he falls into the category of this war. War and plague go together. And next is famine and death. These are result of these two plagues. War and plagues, horsemen, these two result in famine. Because with plagues there will be no food, and it will lead to famine. Famine and then war also leads to death. So war and plague, these both are nothing but one and the same. And famine and death are one and the same. And the one results in the other. So famine and death are dark and black, and represented by Rahu, that is the shadow of Kuja, as I said. So these are the two main beasts that are portrayed in the Unholy Trinity. In this way we can chain up everything back to Kuja, and then Kuja is form of Parabrahma because he is son of Lord Vishnu, the soul of Parabrahma. And that is just a form of Parabrahma in which he starts this apocalypse, and then he later resumes other forms, and finally the Kalki form. So this is how the apocalypse is going to go through. So as a summary, I can tell that what are the four horsemen? War, plagues, famine, death. So war and plagues go together, and can be, this can be simplified into two things: war and plague as one, and famine and death as one. War and plague together can be said to be Kuja, and famine and death together form the Rahu. And Rahu is nothing but a shadow of Kuja. Kuja is son of God, that is sun. So sun and Rahu together form the eclipse. That is what this apocalypse is. Apocalypse is just like a small moment in the biblical time scale. In a Puranic time scale, apocalypse is just a small moment, like eclipse is for us. Eclipse for us is just an hour, even an event of 1 hour time. And this apocalypse is also just like an eclipse in a very huge time scale. evolutionary or whatever time scale you call it as, in a large time scale. So it's just a small moment of time. It's like an eclipse. That is sun. The son of God means Jesus. That is the sun. And Rahu, the shadow. These two are nothing but the beast and the false prophet. And anyhow, Satan is nothing but the representation of God. God created Satan in his... He's also a part of him. So all these things are nothing but one and the same. They all chain up back to one single entity, that is Lord Parabrahma.